Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I am keen to go because this is one of those demos that might have the potential to make a significant difference in your future. If you are at the point where you're thinking about developing online courses as a part of your business model, which so many people are, then I have a treat for you because I'm going to show you Thinkific, which is the tool that I now deliver all of my online courses with. Why is Thinkific important? Because it's a managed service that eliminates so many of the challenges that you face, especially as a first-time course developer. So today on Dotto Tech, Thinkific. I got to give you a few disclaimers as we jump into this demo. First of all, Thinkific is a Vancouver-based company. They're local to me, so immediately I kind of liked them right out of the gate, even before I started using them. But then I started to use their software, and I was looking for a new solution to deliver my new course. I chose Thinkific, and I've been thrilled with the result. As a result, I've also become an affiliate with them. So if you click on my affiliate link, I make money if you happen to purchase the course. So I want to make sure that we're all upfront about that before we even start. Having said all of that, this is a product that I like. This is a product that I'm using, and I think that's the proof is in the pudding. I wouldn't be using a product myself if it didn't work well, because the downside would be way too great, especially delivering courses. I've delivered a lot of courses in my brief online career and used a lot of different techniques for delivering my courses. Some have worked spectacularly well, others have been challenges. Now, typically speaking, when you go to develop and deliver a course, there's a few things that you might not have thought of that you have to consider. First and foremost, there's the marketing of the course. You have to find a way to create sales pages, landing pages. You have to find a way to have an e-commerce solution so people can purchase the course if you're selling the course. So you need that integration to happen so you can properly be paid and so your students can be identified and put into the course. Now, typically speaking, we use something called a membership site for that. It's software that we plug into WordPress and we manage. It's not particularly user-friendly. If you're good at it, it does work quite well, but it does require a fair bit of maintenance, which is one thing that bothered me in the past. So that's your payment gateway and your membership software. Then you've got the actual course delivery modules themselves. And typically speaking, you build the courses in another set of WordPress modules where you've got parent pages and child pages, and you've got a proper way to navigate people through and drip them through the content so you can guide them through a guided process through the course. Again, not incredibly difficult to do, but there's a learning curve, and sometimes things break, and it can be really frustrating when that happens. Plus, you've got a WordPress install going. When WordPress updates, sometimes things break. There can be issues with that as you go along. Then you've got the whole back-end system, managing your users, making sure that they have access to the course content at the appropriate amount of time, that they're sent emails. If there's accreditation involved, you have to find a way to actually test them, make sure that they have learned the content that you've created, etc. There are people that you're going to have to refund your money, so you're going to have to find some sort of way to manage that side of the membership as well and account for people who have asked for refunds or not completed the course or etc. All of those things are part and parcel of developing an online course, all outside of the main purpose of the main work in the course, which is delivering and developing the content itself. So we've got this whole management and marketing area along with the content creation. So where does Thinkific fit in this whole thing? It actually covers off pretty much everything that I've just mentioned, which makes it a fairly massive application if you stop and think about it. It is software as a service. You can sign up and test it out and get a feel for it for free. Now, I'm not going to show you each part of that, or this video would be an hour long, but I'm just going to show you some highlights. And I'm going to start not at the beginning, but in the course content creation space. Because talking about the sales pages, marketing, and e-commerce gets very granular and very specific. And some people might not be interested in selling courses. They might be interested in giving away training or having training for their staff. So the e-commerce side might not be as vital at this particular point. So once you've signed up for Thinkific and you've enrolled, what they'll do is you'll give your site a name, and basically then you've got a hosted, it's almost like a WordPress install, but it's not totally like WordPress. You've got basically a composition engine that allows you to build all of the content for your course. And let's just jump in and take a look at the course that I'm working on right now, which is my Screencasting Made Easy course. And I've got about 90% of the content all locked and loaded and complete. The course is just over halfway through. My students have been taking it, and it's been working flawlessly so far. So most of these modules, they've already taken. Now, the way I've got my course designed is it's broken down into modules and into lessons within the modules. And Thinkific supports that. You can have multiple courses running at the same time. And in this navigation bar down the left-hand side is basically your assets bin. This is what each module and each lesson looks like. And they're broken down almost kind of by data type as opposed to anything else. And the introduction, I've got a little introduction to screencasting set up where I've got the basic chapter title set up. And then I've got my welcome screen, which they see when they start the course, which gives them the schedule of our live events, a few notices of things to do, and welcomes them to the course. Then we get into the course content itself, and I'm going to click on the next one down. And this is actual videos that I've uploaded. Any course that you deliver online today is going to have a heavy video component. One of the really nice things about Thinkific is included in the price of your membership is hosting services for video. And they're using a top-end video provider to host the video. So number one, your video is protected because it's not, say, just on YouTube where anybody can find the video if they know where to look. Instead, it's gated in a proper, in a dedicated video management tool that streams through at high quality, very reliable, but also you're saving anywhere between $40 and maybe $70 or $80 a month on your video hosting because it's all included in the cost of Thinkific, which is a significant because typically speaking, you're probably going to be looking at around $100 a month for software like this. So if you can reduce the number of other tools you use, such as a payment gateway like PayPal, you won't need to spend $20 on PayPal because they've got payment built in. You won't need to spend $40 on your video hosting because that's built in. That all adds up to make it a far more appealing purchase as well. So that's just a little aside on the on some of the extra features. Basically, you go through, and now as far as composing your course, you add elements and bring all of your content together. Now, you might have it all written out in advance. You might work within the editor here to actually create your content. It doesn't matter at this point here. What matters is this is the type of content that it's supported and this is how it's structured. So let's just have a quick boo at the content itself. And if I click here to add content, this is how I add other lessons or other modules here within this one learning container. So we've got the ability to add video. And when you click on video, you just click and you browse and upload the video file, or you can direct it at another video and you can set it up to have the video downloadable, to have it automatically play. You have the ability to have both free trials and paid versions of the course. So you might want to, as part of your marketing, give away, say, the first lesson for free, in which case you could incorporate a video as a part of that. So you can make all of those designations right here. Now, most of these choices are fairly simple, but they're actually very elegant in how they're implemented. So, for example, if you wanted to add a quiz, let me just cancel this. Okay, let me go to the next module. There we go. If we wanted to add a quiz, you can see here that we add questions just by clicking here on add a question, and then you put in your questions, and you can choose whether they're multiple choice or what the correct answer is. You can choose all of that right within here as you set up your quizzes. So you flesh out the content here until you're happy with all of the content you have in place. Beyond quizzes, we also have the ability to add multimedia, which is animations or videos, text, which is just basically a web page that you can, create boldface links within. You can do a fair bit of formatting within that page. You can create a survey. You can have a PDF document incorporated. You can have a discussion forum where you have your class discussed. Now, we don't use the discussion forum for our course. Instead, we direct everybody to Facebook and we have all of our conversations happening in Facebook, but that's your choice. You can have an audio file, so you could create, say, a podcast or a lecture. You also have the ability to download different assets to the people, allowing them to download, your students to download assets. You can incorporate presentations like slideshows and slideshares, and you can also create exams all within the modules. So as you can see, it's a fairly full-featured LMS, or learning management system, built in. But everything is accessible. It's not like it's going to take you all that long to learn to use. I have used their help maybe two or three times as I've developed this course, which is already almost complete. And most of that is relating to account management, not necessarily to course content. Now let's move outside of the editor and let's talk about what the course looks like to students. And fortunately, at any point you can preview the course just by clicking over here and preview it as a student. And I've already launched that page here. So this is what it looks like as a student. So when they first sign up, depending on the number of courses they have access to, they'll be brought into a student dashboard, and you can see that this particular student has not completed any. It tracks our progress through the course, which is just awesome. When we go into the course itself, it loads your course. And then down the side, where we've got all of our building modules, are now the actual content modules. And you can see my welcome screen that we'd seen the HTML version of. Now we see it here. We want to go and watch that video, especially since I say call this watch this video first.
Is my standard opening for each and every.
And the video remembers where you were when last you watched it, and it picks it up from that point. And you can see that it's nice, big, it's streaming through, easy to access. Go into my first lesson, and here I have graphics. I have YouTube videos embedded here in this part, particular part of the course, but you can see that we can flesh out the content really nicely. And each of the modules is delivered in the exact same way. One of the other real benefits of this tool is the fact that we can go in and and we can manage all of our different student. We've got a good management module for managing the students, knowing where they are in the process, emailing to them, giving them notification, also managing people who ask for refunds or drop out of the course, being able to control the students from that perspective. We've got a full management module as well. So if you take a step back and look at what a tool like Thinkific brings to the table for you and I, if you're developing an online course, first and foremost, it's going to help us with the sales process, allowing us to create landing pages and sales pages and marketing pages for the course itself, sometimes using the course content itself as a part of that process, say giving away the first lesson for free, allowing people to see it to determine if they want, which I think is a great strategy and one that I'm actually going to think about. Second, it allows us to create courses using every type of content we can imagine, from video to audio to graphics to text to downloadable documents, allowing quizzes and exams and accreditation coming out of it. You can create certificates coming out of it and proof of completion. That is huge for different types of course content that you're creating. Third, you don't have to manage the environment at all. It's all a managed service for you, so you don't have to worry about updating the software, installing it in WordPress, creating integration between all of your different elements. Now, to be fair, we did integrate this with our CRM with Infusionsoft, and integrating with most CRMs is pretty straightforward with the application. You're going to want to make sure that it does integrate with yours if you already have your CRM in place, but that's just one integration. We didn't have to do everything else. It was all there in place already. We have a good editor for creating, importing our content, managing the flow, knowing where our students are at any point within the process, and then bringing them out the other side with a completed course. For me, the amount of management time in this course, which we are now just about halfway through, has been far less than other courses that I've managed in my own WordPress install. So I'm giving it a thumbs up from that perspective. I'm happy with the progress so far. I'm looking forward to getting more courses and starting to use the marketing aspects and the sales aspect of the tool as well as I kind of get my feet under me in the course. So if you are thinking of developing online courses, I gotta say, spend a little time, have a look at Thinkific. It's going to be worth your time, I promise you. I hope you found today's video to be useful. Now remember, there's three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. Second is subscribe to our newsletter. That way you'll hear about all of our upcoming events, tutorials, courses, etc. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site supported through the generosity of you through the crowdfunding site Patreon. I encourage you to drop by our Patreon page, have a look, and see what perks are available should you choose to support Dotto Tech. And I gotta tell you, the perks be awesome. Until next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.